Well, this morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, joined by two of my favorite guys, Team and Maitre D, Joe Zito, and Chef John Granata from Camille's.
Happy birthday,
happy birthday,
Michaela.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
To be so young and so beautiful like me.
We
it's great,
this
isn't
all day,
it?
You know? Yeah. You know? All right, so tell us about the dish that we're making today.
Well, it's going to sound very odd, but we're going to do chicken with grapes, and we're going to roast it in the oven with caramelized onions, some San Marzano tomatoes, some prosciutto, a little bit of rosemary, some garlic, and we're going to finish it off with a little bit of vintage balsamic vinegar. Now, it sounds strange, delicious, all the ingredients, but they meld together and they roast together really well.
Mm-hmm. And it's a beautiful, rustic Italian recipe. And of course, you always come to me for the pronunciation.
Oh, yes.
This is pollo arrosto con uva.
Pollo arrosto con uva.
Yes.
Did
excellent.
I get it today?
That sounds great.
Kind of Italian for the day. Right. All right, so the portion that we're making today, roughly how many people will that feed?
Well, this is for two, but you just increase the this particular recipe twice for four. And, you know, if you look, there's really only five ingredients here.
Very simple dish.
It take you 5 minutes to put it together, throw it in the oven, 1 hour, come back, you got an incredible dinner.
It's going to be terrific.
Perfect. I'm excited. I'm going to eat a grape and send it over to you. For now, we're going to be heading back to the kitchen. How's it going, birthday girl? Oh, thank you, Mary. It is going excellent. We are about to start cooking our chicken. This will not stop, apparently. All right, so John, tell us how we're prepping and what kind of chicken are we using?
All right, we're using a split chicken breast on the bone. I like to keep it on the bone when I roast them so that the juices stay in, and you just get a lot more flavor in the sauce from it.
That's interesting.
So if you're afraid to use chicken on the bone, generally you want to go 20 minutes per pound for the chicken itself. Mm-hmm. So if that helps out, you know, what I do for this particular dish is you got to close to 2 pounds here. I like to go close to 1 hour.
Okay.
Okay. So you want to liberally salt and pepper.
Liberally.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Right. You want to get some olive oil going. Okay. You want to go skin side down.
Okay, skin side down. Now, why do you do skin side down?
Because you want to get some nice color on the top of the skin, because when we put it in the casserole, we're going to cover it with foil.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to back up a little bit. And Joe's
having a party.
Joe's famous line is,
make sure that you're dressed when you do this stuff, okay? Because it'll hurt.
Not in your birthday suit.
But also, seriously, keep the kids away from the stove when you're doing stuff like this. Because you're safe.
Stand
behind me.
All right, so about how long are we putting that in the pan for?
We're going to sear this on both sides until you get the color you want, which is going to take about 3 minutes on each side. Once you flip it over, when we come back, we're going to show you how to finish the sauce in the pan. Mm-hmm. We're going to throw this in the oven on a 400-degree oven, and I'm going to show you a finished product that you're not going to believe.
With some wine.
Okay, so everything is going to continue to be in that pan, and we're literally just going to take that and put it in the oven.
We could do it that way, or we could just transfer it to a casserole dish, whatever you're more comfortable with.
Okay, well, that's nice, easy cleanup, though, too.
It's easy ingredients, and it's an easy dish, and you're really going to like this. You see how you get the color on there?
Looks good.
Yep.
Excellent. Okay, perfect. Well, we are going to finish this dish, and that's going to keep bubbling and sizzling and popping all over the place. For now, back to you.
Happy birthday.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef John Granata from Camille's, Joe Zito, TV's Maitre D. We're making roasted chicken with grapes.
Smoking Joe over
Smoking
there.
Joe, Smoking Joe. I didn't tell you it was my birthday, too.
Oh, happy birthday to you, too.
Happy birthday to Will.
I just want to hear him sing again. All right, what do we got going on?
All right. We have a roasted chicken with grapes, and we're going to show you how to finish it right now. I took chicken on the bone, and I seared it on both sides. Right now, we want to put some onions in it.
Mm.
I pre-caramelize these onions.
Okay.
All right, the onions are very vital because it's going to give off sweetness, as will the grapes. Parma prosciutto.
I'm
going to cut that up, throw that in.
Beautiful.
This looks amazing.
And this is the funny part.
Ready? Okay, now
some grapes.
Okay.
Salt and pepper.
Right.
Now this is very easy, right?
This is something, you could make tonight. Simple and easy to do. Didn't take you very long either to...
fresh rosemary.
Right.
Garlic. Very vital.
Okay.
It's about a clove and a half. Put as much as you want in it.
Right, yep.
Right?
Not expensive either, by the way.
It's not bad.
These are San Marzano tomatoes, whole tomatoes. I crushed up with my hand, about a 28-ounce can. You could use any kind of whole tomatoes that you like.
You know what? In a lot of dishes that I, you know, even cook at home, I like the whole tomatoes better. This, you get like a rich flavor.
And they do such a great job packing them nowadays. Yeah. This is a vintage balsamic vinegar. You want to use a good balsamic because you won't get too much of an acid taste out of it.
Right.
Right? You want to put about a quarter cup to a half a cup in, depending on how much you did.
Right.
See, that stops everything from cooking.
The aroma's great.
Yeah, you can really smell it, huh?
Yep. And...
now, what's going to happen to the grapes? Will those grapes cook down?
They're going to break down.
They are going to break down.
They're going to explode.
Okay.
And everybody's going to come together in one and make a big sauce in there. And that's why I like to keep it on the bone, the chicken, because it's also going to lend to the sauce.
All right.
All right. So you could do this. You could put foil on this and put it right in the oven just as is. Or you could put it in a casserole if you feel most safe with that.
Right, okay.
So you're going to go right in the oven with it.
See how beautiful
it is. How long? We got the oven on, what, about 425?
425.
Right.
And we're
going to
go about an hour.
Okay.
Right? And then when we pull it out after an hour.
Wow, look at that.
We're going to look at something like this.
That looks fantastic.
And while you're plating that up, and of course you might say, we have a beautiful dish here. It's rustic, delicious, and it's very cost effective.
Right.
So what wine would go with grapes?
What wine would go with grapes?
My selection this morning is a traditional French classic, simple Beaujolais Village. This is not Beaujolais Nouveau.
Mm-hmm.
This is from the Beaujolais appellation in France, Louis Jadot in this case. This is a $9 bottle of wine. Sometimes people forget about true Beaujolais, and it's one of the French classics. It will go beautifully with this because it's very fruit forward, but it's a soft wine, so it won't overpower all of these wonderful flavors.
Right.
And you know what? This is one of the wine values of the year all the time, a nice bottle of Beaujolais.
Well, I mean, you know, between this dish here, which is, you know, a very inexpensive dish, an inexpensive bottle of wine, but also a good tasting bottle.
And this is a great summer wine as we get into the nice weather and all.
Right.
It's very good for sipping. You don't have to have a lot of hearty foods with it, too, and it's still a nice red.
Okay.
And have a little chill to it at times.
Nice. All right. Things going on at Camille's that we need to know. Summertime is a fast approaching.
Summertime is fun time.
Mother's Day.
Mother's Day, oh yes.
Noon to 4:30. Chef Granata, fabulous menu along with Chef Suave. And it's not so much a limited menu. It's a menu of the Camille's classics and all his great specials. And always a little something for the kids, too. And you know what? You should make your reservations and don't delay because it's one of the biggest days of the year there.
Yeah. Any big specials? Anything we're cooking up for Mom?
Oh, Mom always likes lobster. So we got lobster all over the board on this menu. So we're going to do it in homemade lobster raviolis. We do a lobster casserole dish with shrimp and scallops and king crab meat. Baked in a casserole so Mom doesn't have to get dirty.
Fantastic.
Sounds like a plan, doesn't it, Will?
It does sound like a plan. Dear old Mom will love that. I'm going to give this a taste here.
So, how'd that all come together?
Mm.
Isn't that beautiful?
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? So you have to be open-minded when you see the ingredients at first, but when you see them all come together, you're like, wow, that really did work.
That's fantastic. Thanks, guys.
A symphony of flavor.
Thank you so much. If you want this recipe, all you have to do is head to our website, WPRI.com.